Why are we all here? To buy and sell art, bitches. I'm Casey Jane Ellison, and welcome to Touching the Art Miami. Bienvenido a Miami. La música, las bebidas. Oh my God, is that my ex? Hide me. It's like I get it now, you know what I mean? Straight up, like I'm buying property here. So here we go. It's so f***ing relaxing. First week of December, the entire art world flies here, not only to kill time before they die, but to make that money, honey, money, honey. I need a job. Hey, we're here at Basel, but it's just one of dozens of fairs that exhibit hundreds of galleries and make millions of dollars. I'm exploring the booths, I'm talking to the galleristas, and I'm gonna find out once and for all if the business of art really is the best way to outrun mortality. Come on, let's go. By the way, I'm sorry I called you guys bitches. That was rude. You're not bitches. Basel is overwhelming, okay? You can smell the commerce in the air. It's like, look at all of these blurred images of artwork. We can't even afford to license these babies. Babies? Why are we here? Why are we here? It's like, I get it now. You know what I mean? This image is like a truth that I didn't know that I was seeking. It's like, I can die now. Linda Yablonsky, you're a writer, author, art world institution. Why are we all here in Miami?
Because of the weather.
Do you hate Miami?
I don't hate it. I don't love it. I didn't come at first because I thought I didn't need to.
How did it become an unmissable event?
The collectors started coming because there were nice hotels, there was nice weather. I don't know, I can't account for the way other people behave. But it was easy to let your hair down in a place like this where it's very casual and you go half naked most of the time. I don't. It's a place that encourages parties and socializing, and when you bring at the time 30 or 40,000, now closer to 100,000 people to this tiny strip of beach, and they spend the whole day looking at art, and they need something to do at night. It became a promotional vehicle for fashion brands, and they had this very, kind of threadbare, if I can say that, connection to art. It became so much about partying and promotion that I got turned off because I like looking at art. A lot of people came and didn't even bother going to the fair. And it is fun. I mean, it's fun. There's nothing not fun about a party. It was exhausting for me. And then I'd go home and fall into a deep depression because I just hadn't slept in a week. I've been here for 2 days. I have absolutely no idea what's going on in the rest of the world.
Do you think Miami is about the artist or the collector? Like, if the artist shows us truth, what does the collector show us?
Artists don't create economies. They can't do that. That's not their job. I guess collectors, if they're in business, do, if they're able to employ people.
Do you think that our insignificance is never more clear than in Miami Art Basel?
Do you think life is meaningless?
No, just that kind of like vibe.
Well, everyone needs a few days off. I mean, it is amazing that this many people can take time out of their jobs and businesses and be here.
What is this? What is this place? I'm here with Elena Soboleva, who's a specialist at Artsy, which is an online platform for selling art, educating the public about art, and what else?
Artsy's mission is to bring the art world into the online sphere. So we serve as the architecture of the art world online. We work with collectors, museums, galleries to bring everything into an online fold.
Because it's really hard for young emerging artists to make actual money.
Well, you know, there's artists who work with online as a medium, and then there's other young artists who whose work goes online and certainly propagates the whole young hot artist trend.
Do you have any advice for young emerging artists trying to sell their work online?
get on Instagram and Artsy.
Why Instagram?
I just find that right now it's a very much image-based economy, and right now artist images are getting disseminated via online means, and Artsy is a perfect example of that, wherein we have a fair preview and collectors from all over the world can go and browse and look, you know, a week in advance all the images that will be there, and suddenly you have an audience that's much more global looking at the work. And Instagram becomes sort of a neat in the studio tool where collectors can get a real insight into how an artist's practice sort of varies and evolves in a really unfiltered approach.
Great. It seems easy enough, right? I just have one last question. What do you do to your skin to make it look that flawless?
Oh, I wish. Sunscreen once in a while. That's about it.
It's just jeans.
I'm from Russia. I'm from Canada and Russia, from the cold, the north. It's
gorgeous. Well, I think I've escaped death for one more day here at Art Basel. Maybe even made life worth living. If not for me, then maybe for you. You know, showing my work at Art Basel is probably the highlight of my career. I feel really amazing about the time I've spent here. I'm gonna go drop off my resume at some restaurants. Love you guys. Money, honey.
Bush is not a terrible thing.
That gatekeeper mentality will not set you free, bitch. My crush is inside running a panel. That's him. Miami wore me out.